What's up, guys, and happy Halloween. It is the 31st, obviously. Well, not obviously. If you guys don't know what Halloween is, it's October 31st, which maybe this was a very, like, self-centered American way of thinking, but I literally thought we invented Halloween. But I was listening to a podcast, and apparently it was invented actually in Europe. Whenever I, like, see Halloween, it's always United States. So I don't know. But that was very interesting when I, learned the back history on Halloween. It was the reason why kids go trick-or-treating. It was to reward the kids for keeping the spirits away by wearing costumes. The adults felt like if there was little kids dressed in costumes and stuff like that, it would scare off the spirits. So that's the reason why trick-or-treating came about, because they were rewarding the kids. I think, like I said, I heard it off of a podcast, could be totally false, didn't do any more research after that on it. But anyways, this is not the history of Halloween. We are getting ready. It's about 5 o'clock and it is so hot in California. We either usually on Halloween, we usually have either a rainy Halloween or a very hot one. And it's definitely a hot one, which is very interesting because it's been very cold actually this week. Of course, the day we have to put like layers of clothing on and face makeup, it's hot. But hopefully when we get down there, it's a little bit closer to the beach areas, so maybe it'll be a little bit cooler. We are going to the West Hollywood Carnival. It's been canceled the last 2 years due to COVID, so they finally have it back. And it's a mile stretch on Santa Monica Boulevard in West Hollywood. Super diverse area. If you guys don't know what West Hollywood is, it's very diverse and there's a lot of different cultures out there. They're very happy and excited to have it back. All day on the news, they were just like, yeah, it's back, back, back. So we're gonna go. There's food trucks, DJs, and then like a lot of extravagant costumes. Fortunately, my costume's not gonna be as extravagant. My sister's currently doing her makeup, so I'm going with my sister and my dad. So we went to the thrift store over the weekend and just like try to look for pieces. My best idea to quickly think of a costume, because at that time I just got stressed out, so I was like, oh good, I have to think of a costume. So I'm gonna be Coraline. I like Coraline. I think I've always wanted to be Coraline anyways, and I love the blue and the yellow. If you guys haven't seen my previous videos, I wear a lot of yellow. So I have a yellow rain jacket. My sister has yellow rain boots, and I just bought a wig off of Amazon. So I'm gonna be Coraline. So my sister's gonna do my makeup, but she's finishing her makeup right now, and my dad's finishing up the finishing touches on his costume. He's gonna be like a steampunk, I don't know, dead person. I don't know the exact, like, I'll show you guys once it's all complete. Yeah. Let's get ready, guys. I'm excited. You know, it's a Tuesday and I really didn't think we were gonna do much. Come on, Tuesday, Halloween on a Tuesday is so horrible, but my sister and my dad were like, let's do it. So I was like, okay, let's do it. So I'm in the spirit, even though I only slept 4 hours last night. Anyways, happy Halloween. Let's get dressed. So first thing I did was wash my face. Now I'm gonna put my contacts on, because I'm blind as a bat. These are still my trials. Contacts in. Now we're gonna get started with the makeup. Welcome to my sister does my makeup. The makeup's gonna look like this, somewhat inspired like that. I hired my sister.
Yep.
Just letting you know, if you wanted this to be a tutorial on Coraline it's makeup, it's not. It's amateur tries to do Coraline makeup.
It's like the first time I've ever put makeup on.
Yeah, look at, she does first time, so.
Like it's hard.
Like it's hard.
Like it's hard to look like a clown.
Yeah, so she's, yeah, she can't tell, she's gonna be a clown. She's LeBron James. You mean all the time, the flop?
Do you wash your face?
Yes. It feels rough though.
Stop talking. Well, your eyebrows are
thin? Thanks.
Yeah, no, they're not thin, but they're pretty, like, thin.
Yeah, no, I have really thin eyebrows, so. Sometimes I think they don't exist when I put my glasses on.
They're not that thin.
Nice, daddy-o. Dad, you want to show them your work in progress outfit? All thrift stored. And then my dad created this out of, guess what? One, two, three.
A tutu.
A tutu.
Tutu, I made my sleeves and my tie.
Nice. I like it. My poor baby doesn't understand. I wanted to take them, but they strongly advise no dogs, probably because it's gonna be extremely packed. Do I look like the Grim Reaper from Pilota, don't I? I just need a skateboard. So we're following the, my sister's following the Rebecca Seals Coraline makeup tutorial. So I'll put it in the description below. Okay, so this is how the makeup looks right now. I look like a sad doll when I don't smile. Yeah. You know, it kind of looks like Tupac. That comic book. This is the look. Now it's my dad's turn.
I'm gonna try to get rid of your eyebrows.
This is what he wants. Not bad for an amateur artist, huh? Secret talent unlocked. Are you trying to look more scary, Dad?
We got his beard pretty white. We used this LA Girl Pro Color full coverage. We were having a hard time finding like a white makeup. We didn't really want to use costume makeup. And my sister's seen this. This is the spray that she used. We're also using this Jumbo NYX pencil. One of the ladies recommended this. But I mean, you have to color in your face with this, so it's kind of harsh on your skin. And she's also using the NYX professional makeup brush. This is what we're using to fill in the circles. Our three faces done by Vanny. Look it. She says she's an amateur. I think my dad's has been the best. Look at that. Sheesh. Contour, shading. Man, yep. You're pretty scary, homie. He loves this. Now for the outfit. I have two different options. I had just told my dad that I was never gonna wear skinny jeans again, that I was gonna throw away all my skinny jeans because I'm repulsed by the idea of ever putting my legs back into skinny jeans. But here I go, skinny jeans. So it was kind of, the shirt kind of seemed like she either had it all the way zipped up or she had a star sweater and some people wore striped shirts. Either we're gonna go with the blue shirt underneath, which is shiny and it kind of matches that. But I did see this striped turtleneck that I have, and I honestly think I like this color combo more. So we're gonna try both of these on and see which one looks better. This is the wig that I got from Amazon. It's actually pretty good quality, honestly. And then I got, these were like the soonest delivery that I could get for hairnet, so it did somewhat the job. Let's try this on and see. I put the skinny jeans on. Can't believe I wore these every day to like work. This is crazy. Okay, I'm gonna change. Okay, I'm gonna put the wig on right now, but this is the first option. This is the striped shirt. So far, I think I like the striped shirt more, but let me put the wig on and then I guess we'll see. So like I said, I got these like nylon covers. I thought it was gonna be more like elastic-y. I've never actually wore one of those things. My sister was like, oh, you're gonna need that. Right. I'm gonna just put my hair like this. And this is the nylon. I got a big cabeza, so. See, the wig is pretty good. I feel like I kind of just look like a pop figure. And then she has like this B clip. We're going more based off of this look now. The other girl, we kind of just felt like she looked like Corpse Bride a little bit, which isn't bad. It's just not the look we were going for. Okay, this is this girl's version of Coraline. She kind of has it like split like that, but I think if I do that, it just kind of looks a little weird. I actually kind of like it like pinned back like this. Yeah, huh? Better than this. Yeah, I think I'm gonna pin it back right here too. I don't know what you guys think, pinned? Oh God! Daniel, you look good! Wow. You look real good. Thrift store? And then my dad put that skirt we were talking about, he put the ends on there, and he also used a piece right here, and for his sleeves, look real good, Dad. And then his kilt, Danny, also thrift store.
Yep.
Real cute.
All these costumes for both.
Look at, she used all these colors on her eye makeup. See? Nice. Okay, my dad was right. I forgot the boots. Okay, so I think we're
got all the pieces together. I think I'm gonna go with this because yeah, it's supposed to cool down tonight, but it's short sleeve. The other one's long sleeve, and I just feel like with a lot of people, I'm probably gonna get sweaty. I'm already sweaty in this rain jacket. So let's go to West Hollywood. Let's experience this for the first time ever. People. You ready? Look at the little doggy. There's so much hate in this world. What's up guys? So it's the next day now. Oh my gosh, it was so hard to get up for work this morning, but I did. I made it through. Kind of lost my voice. It's a little scratchy today and I'm feeling pretty worn down. So it was a lot of fun though, but like we had to park so far because there was like no parking. I mean, parking in LA is already insane. And then with an event going on, there was like no parking. So yeah, I didn't really talk over there at all because there was like so many people. There's multiple stages, but they were all like bumping the same music. So I didn't want to copyright or anything like that. But I hope you enjoyed the costumes that I was able to capture. Thing about it was like a lot of the restaurants on that actual block or a couple of blocks were all like a lot of them were shut down, and I was like, this is a perfect opportunity to get a lot of business. The businesses that were open were so packed. So we ended up walking up like a mile away and we went to, can't remember the name of it. Honestly, the food was not good at all. It was like, I don't know how it's world famous. It was not that good. The milkshake was so tiny. If you guys seen Pulp Fiction when he said $5 milkshake, This was a $10 milkshake. Crazy. And it was so thin and small, like I would understand if it was like a granddaddy milkshake, but it wasn't. So yeah, we just kind of walked through that. It was like probably took us like 45 minutes to walk from one side to the end. Where they had like the main stage, there was a point where I had to grab the back of my sister's like costume because I was like so that area was not comfortable, but yeah, it was an experience. I'm glad I got to experience it. I'm happy nothing broke out. I don't know, I always get afraid because there's like a lot of hate, and WeHo is known for a lot of diverse culture, especially for the LGBTQ community. So I always get afraid that like people try to like do something harmful to the community, and they're just trying to like live their life out there. I mean, that's their community. There was some religious groups that were trying to like preach, but I don't think anybody really let it bother them. Luckily, there was no fights, nothing like that. So everybody was just able to have a good time. But yeah, so hope you guys enjoy it.